season is one short summer away, and with Max Hall gone, many fans are wondering who will be the next quarterback.
The quarterback battle has four contestants. I spoke with quarterback coach Brandon Doman about the individual strengths of the hopefuls, starting with two players recently returned from missions, James Lark and Jason Munns.
James is really what you want him to look like. He's 6'3 and 215 pounds, and real put together that way, and you know, big strong arm guy, and he's mobile too, and an explosive athlete. So I think you'd kind of take the two strengths, and he's kind of a bit of both of them. Just home off a mission though, so it's going to take him a little bit more time to physically catch up to these guys. Jason Munns, he's 6'5 and 240 pounds. He's a big strong athlete. He, you know, he'll be a drop back passer, will be his strength. And but he's a, we use the word grit a lot around here, and that guy he's the type of guy we're going to want on this team no matter what happens.
One of the newest and most talked about players on the team this year is freshman Jake Heaps.
He's done great in my opinion. He's a very humble kid. He's very coachable, and he understands the game very well. He's came in and, in my opinion, he's done a phenomenal job with, you know, grasping the offense, the concepts, and just making plays. You know, he's a playmaker. He's done that in high school, and he's continuing to do it here in college.
You know, Jake is a young man that's been just trained really well from a young age. He's a real natural passer, probably as natural and as talented of a freshman passer as I've seen. And the fact that he can walk out here and make real difficult throws in a college setting is pretty impressive. And so that would be his strength. He's got a good strong arm, and then a savvy football player. He's been trained well. He understands things at a very, you know, young age.
Finally, the player with the most experience at the quarterback position is junior Riley Nelson.
Yeah, Riley is a real good athlete. He's a real mobile quarterback. Runs around really well. He's kind of a stout, real put together guy, and so I think that would, you know, if we can do some things that would suit that talent for him, it would allow for him to have some success. And then, you know, he's a smart guy. He's a real analytical guy. It matters to him, you know, make all the reads. And I think he's really improving in the pass game right now. So you couple the two together, and that would be pretty darn good.
Riley, he can move. You know, he's a very mobile quarterback. Jake, he sits in the pocket, and, you know, he throws a really good ball. And James, you know, he does both of them. But at the same time, Riley can also throw the ball too. So I don't want people to kind of paint that picture that he can't throw the ball and he just runs, because, you know, he's definitely a great asset to the team.
Having Harvey Unga back for another season, as well as an experienced offensive line and wide receivers, will be a tremendous advantage for any quarterback.
To have the O-line and then Harvey, which is such a big part of the success of a quarterback, being able to run the ball and having the defense worried about that kind of a threat, really helps open up passing lanes and takes stress off the quarterback. The quarterback doesn't feel like he has to do everything all the time.
I would say Harvey would be our biggest asset right now, and that we can run the football and be very effective doing it. And if you're effective running the game, it's going to cause the defenses to have to play run-style defenses, and that'll make it easier in the pass game.
Although he's in the middle of competing for a spot, Riley says he sees the benefit in sharing his experience with the younger players.
I find that you probably learn most when you have opportunities to teach, because then you have to take whatever knowledge you do have and formulate it so that someone else can understand it. And many times when you do that, you got to simplify things, and in your own mind, you learn it better. So I still look for opportunities to help those other guys out. Now, I'm not their coach, but if the coach is saying something that maybe is difficult for a player to understand, I can offer that player perspective.
Regardless of who is chosen to throw the first ball of the 2010 season, there's a lot more to the position of quarterback than what is seen on the field.
I think the most difficult thing is just the volume. When I say volume, I'm talking academics. I'm talking the BYU environment here, being really the flag bearer of this football team, regardless of age, and then football. So as you couple all those things together, that's pretty tough for a young guy to manage all that at once. The most important thing is going to be productivity. And at the end of the day, our team's going to have a pretty good idea of who the most productive guy is.
So any word on who the most productive guy might be?
Make sure your TV's on and you're in the stadium. You'll see the guy run out there, and hopefully you'll cheer him on.
As Coach Doman said, fans won't know for sure who the next quarterback will be till the season starts, but we'll keep you updated on all things.